The fact that people are legitimately mad at this film shows me that media literacy is a goddamn corpse, and the death of mainstream film won't come from the strikes, but from people not being able to handle anything aside from Disney and the MCU. One thing that people keep talking about is, Barbie is anti-male, Barbie hates men! But it's really fucking not. In actuality, the Barbies in this movie love their Kens. It's just not every Barbie's love is romantic, like our main Barbie. And even our human lead is in a happy, borderline sitcom-esque marriage with her husband. When Barbie and Ken come to the real world, Ken mistakenly interprets patriarchy as toxic masculinity because he thinks it will get him the love and respect and horses that he feels he hasn't been getting in Barbieland. Because his whole character arc is him learning that he has to be mature enough to create his own identity and his own happiness that doesn't hinge on him being connected to Barbie. It's an almost floodlights in the dark level reference to so many young men turning to toxic masculinity online. Your Andrew Tates, your alpha male mindsets, dating gurus, etc, etc. But it's not like the Barbies are completely innocent here either. Barbieland is only presented as a net positive to Barbies. The whole place is stemmed on toxic femininity. Margot Barbie thinks that everything is a beautiful utopia of sisterhood and bonding and love and social awareness. But the Barbies are fucking mean! Whether it's being dismissive or just outright awful to anyone different, seriously, Weird Barbie and Midge could not catch a fucking break in this film. Or even when their friend is expressing panic about her body, their reaction is to scream it to the heavens and start dry heaving in disgust. Not to mention their delusion about their effect on the real world. This is so obviously making fun of those activists who've lived in wealth all their lives, thinking that the vapid strain of activism has helped the ignorant poor and the disenfranchised, when in reality, the only people it's helped are other wealthy, sheltered activists. Hell, near the end, Ken admits that he only flocked to patriarchy because of the horses, respect, and beer, and that once he saw all the other stuff, he actually lost interest but had to keep it going. And we actually see patriarchy presented as a good thing after the big War of the Kens, when all the Kens come together in this big song number of unity and brotherhood to uplift each other and celebrate the masculine experience. Which is what patriarchy is supposed to be. People keep saying, the movie's woke, the movie is too woke. But the way that even a child could see that the vast majority of times they used a woke term, it was so fucking tongue-in-cheek. It's literally poking fun at people who shove collegiate-level words into the most mundane posts about why fan service is bad or why your ship is icky. We verbatim get a scene where a bunch of middle school girls regurgitate debunked internet discourse about Barbie in order to make her feel bad. For fuck's sake, one of them calls Barbie a fascist! Just like the current schism of people labeling anyone they don't like a fascist so they can justify not liking them. The only times where the social commentary was meant to be genuine or the writers standing on the pulpit was America Ferrera's big venting speech about the perpetual balancing act that is being a woman. And while the speech itself is brilliantly delivered, even I frowned a bit at the line, you have to be a boss, but you can't be mean. You have to lead, but you can't squash other people's ideas. It is 2023. I implore people to realize that there is a difference between being assertive and being a bitch. All of this isn't to say you're bad if you didn't like the movie. Personally, I feel like they could have used this narrator a little less. Though, the narrator calling out the director for putting in a scene where Barbie is crying about being ugly, yet casting Margot fucking Robbie, was pretty funny. And I know that not everyone enjoys camp. However, it's just disheartening how some people are lambasting the movie as some big misandrist hit piece, when, in reality, the message is more in line with the human experience is hell for everyone no matter what's in your pants, and ideas are the only things keeping us from dying cold, miserable, agonizing deaths. One final note. I've seen some people express disappointment that Mattel wasn't the main villain in the movie. But I think some people are interpreting that as the movie saying, "Oh, Mattel's a good company." And to those people, I warmly ask, bitch, did you wake up blind, deaf, and stupid this morning? The whole thing with Mattel is a bunch of disconnected bigwigs putting on the airs of empowering little girls while acknowledging that they've managed to commodify those ideas into a fiscal empire of glitter and plastic. The only reason they got involved is because they don't want people knowing that the whole company relies on a magical world of someone else's creation. Hell, that's why they closed the portal between worlds at the end. Honestly, anyone who thinks anyone, even a movie literally called Barbie, can be pro-Mattel needs to remember the cardinal rule. Never ask a woman her age, a man his salary, or Mattel what they did to Ever After High.